I'm noticing a reoccurring family theme lately. But unlike Forever Philly showing us what can happen as a result of family members failing to recognize growth and change, parental guidance gave us a glimpse into the inverse extreme of being too encouraging. I've never personally seen parents exactly like Bo Hothoof and Windy Whistles before. The closest experiences I have are with parents who believe that their kids can do no wrong. And to be brutally honest, Rainbow Dash's parents were much less obnoxious. Criticizing and trying to teach the kids of these parents in any way drives them to lash out at the teacher, coach, counselor, guardian, whatever it may be. They often spoil their child egotistically or materialistically, making it extremely difficult to teach them as they become older. Occasionally, one of those kids will become successful through raw talent but still retain an ego, much like we see with Rainbow Dash. The rest of the time, they become someone that I would generally compare to Zephyr Breeze or Trixie in terms of ego, skill, and work ethic. I have found that encouraging your charges is important, but they will inevitably make mistakes, and sometimes they know when this is the case. Reinforcing a notion that they are the best when they know that they are not will sometimes leave them frustrated from not knowing how to improve, thus fostering some of the resentment that we saw from Rainbow Dash. But the embarrassing and potentially destructive side of this episode's lesson is actually the easy part. Many of us sympathize with Rainbow Dash in either the past or present tense. That's why many people believe that Rainbow Dash was right to snap at them. Through Bo's and Wendy's antics and the multitude of people who relate closely to Rainbow Dash in this episode, many missed the unadulterated love that Bo Hothoof and Windy Whistles have for their daughter and the happiness that they felt for her success. They're good parents, quite frankly. At every point in Rainbow Dash's young life, they gave everything they had to building her up because they knew that she had a lot of potential and loved her enough to want to see her fulfill it. And then, when Rainbow Dash did fulfill that potential in spades, I may add, her parents didn't even try to take that glory for themselves for having facilitated it, like I've seen so many others try to do. They simply stated that they always knew that she was destined for greatness. Even if it was overbearing at times, it's certainly better than not having that at all. And while we all know an overbearing parent, we also know many who are absent and have seen how that can make the lives of their children very difficult. Choosing instead to focus on cases like Rainbow Dash's family, I have found that people will sometimes focus on the negative aspects of their family to a point where they lose sight of what they have to be thankful for. This is especially frustrating for those who weren't as lucky to observe from the outside. It comes off as spoiled or bratty and certainly ungrateful, and sometimes it actually is. That's why Scootaloo was so angry when Rainbow Dash was ungrateful for the affection that she received and gave little to none in return. Since Scootaloo views Rainbow Dash the same way that her parents do, seeing that affection get rejected hit Scootaloo just as hard. Perhaps it was even worse for Scootaloo, considering that she watched someone throw away something that she has always wanted for herself. I'm certain that most of us can sympathize with that as well. The solution, as always, is balance, empathy, and communication. I won't deny for a second that Bo Hothoof and Windy Whistles were obnoxiously overbearing in expressing their love for Rainbow Dash, but at no point in time did I see Rainbow herself try to calmly and explicitly ask them to stop, or explain the effects that they were having on her. Nor did anyone involved, Scootaloo included, try to understand what the others were going through at any point. This, like all things, built up until it exploded and drove Rainbow Dash to snap the way she did. Put simply, you can't do that. Interpersonal problem solving has a ladder of escalation that should be patiently climbed and attempted to de-escalate at every opportunity. Skipping straight to the top rung does nothing but cause the types of problems that we saw, oftentimes making them even worse. Admittedly, the lesson given in the episode was skewed heavily towards what Rainbow Dash needed to learn, but that doesn't mean that the lesson is not applicable, as those of us who relate to Rainbow Dash, myself included, are likely guilty of snapping at our parents unnecessarily in the same way. But that also doesn't mean that Windy Whistles and Bo Hothoof and the rest of our families didn't learn anything either through these things. In the case of Windy Whistles and Bo Hothoof, we saw them get embarrassed, much in the same way when Rainbow Dash finished her apology show. They just needed to get a taste of their own medicine, the same way that Rainbow Dash often does herself. As for the rest of us, it's more likely than not that with time, the rest of our families will learn to respect our boundaries. It wasn't until Scootaloo pointed out to Rainbow Dash that she would rather have over-enthusiastic parents than absent parents that Rainbow Dash remembered to be grateful for what she had. It wasn't until she reached out to her parents that Windy Whistles and Bo Hothoof understood what they were putting Rainbow Dash through. And through this mutual understanding, everyone learned to be closer than ever to their loved ones. I am confident that we all have a Bo Hothoof, Windy Whistles, Scootaloo, and Rainbow Dash in our lives, even if they aren't biological family. But once we realize this and balance the support that we give while being grateful for the praise that we receive, then we'll be able to support and praise each other to success much in the same way. And that's the moral of the story. If you have any comments, critiques, or suggestions, you can send me a message by following BronyBuck on Tumblr or sending an email to bronydebates@gmail.com. This video was supported by all of my generous supporters on Patreon. Please check out their content links in the description. You can also see how you can join them in supporting my channel and what you would get in return. Have a great day, and I look forward to hearing from all of you soon.